May the name of the Lord be glorified. We are living in a world that no peace. There is unrest and unhappiness, fear and sorrow everywhere. The message of Christmas was peace on earth because Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace, was born to save sinners. People all over the world celebrate Christmas without the Prince of Peace and without peace in their hearts. But those who accept Jesus Christ as their personal Savior and Lord in their hearts, by grace through faith, have peace in their heart, and they are the peacemakers. That is why it is written, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they are called the children of God." Matthew chapter 5, verse 9. Therefore, let us focus on such a peacemaker in the Bible. One of the greatest peacemaker, none other than a woman called Abigail, that we see in 1 Samuel chapter 25. A mismatched marriage between an ungodly man with a godly woman. Nabal was a filthy rich man of the tribe of Judah and from the family of Caleb. No wonder the parents of Abigail arranged this marriage with Nabal, thinking to have a better and prosperous life for their lovely daughter. But Nabal was a man of short temper, arrogant, harsh, and ill-doing in all his dealings. He was a fool, focusing only on his wealth and his self-motives. No one could reason with him. Whereas Abigail, a wise, prudent, noble, very beautiful, and a charming, godly woman. Can you imagine how she was adjusted to live such a husband? She had a cozy house, rich in everything, servants and maidens to serve her, but she lacked a spiritual atmosphere. She could not enjoy the love and warm closeness of her husband. Did she ever complain? Did she ever boast herself on her beauty and wisdom? Did she ever thought of divorcing him and run back to her parents? No, she lived by faith in the sovereign God of Israel. She believed that if God had joined her with Nabal, God will take care of her. She had decided to live with him till the death depart. Nothing can separate them but God. That is the marriage vow before God. Now, some dangerous event that had happened in that family. A dangerous conflict between David and Nabal. There was a happy celebration of sharing dips was going on. It was a joyful occasion with feast with family and friends. David was in the wilderness taking refuge from King Saul, and his people and Nabal's folks became acquainted, and David protected and helped them. So David sent his men to greet Nabal and expecting some food from the feast. But Nabal not only refused to give food to them, but insulted David by saying, "Who is David? Who is the son of Jesse? There are many servants nowadays who break away each one from their masters. Shall then I take my bread and my water and my meat that I have prepared for my shearers and give it to men which I do not even know where they are from?" What a proud, harsh, selfish and arrogant words of Nabal against David and his men, who helped them, protected them, rescued them in the wilderness. When David heard this, he got angry and swore to take revenge by destroying the household of Nabal. When Abigail knew this, she recognized the seriousness of the situation and dangerous than she thought. Her wisdom rose up to face the situation to save her family from the anger of David. Verse 18. Then Abigail made haste. That means immediately, not even wasting time, to discuss with her husband or get permission from him. She put together plenty of food for David and his men and proceeded to meet David down the hill and face the angry David face to face. What a courageous woman was she! She did not dare to show herself to the sword of angry David. When she saw them, she fell at his feet and said, verse 24 onwards, "O me, my Lord, on me, let this iniquity be." There was a pin drop silent in that wilderness. David's sword fell off from his hand. Men with swords could not believe what was happening. A woman at David's feet asking pardon, and she was asking for forgiveness for her husband. Following her conversation with David, she used my Lord, 14 times to open her heart to David, to let him know that she knew David as the king of the land. But her husband did not know him. He knew, but refused to admit that he knew David. Then she verbalized that her husband is a foolish man with pride and arrogance. What a thankless man was he for those who protected and rescued his folks in the wilderness. He had repaid evil for good. Following her conversation, she was focusing on God and David, nothing about her husband. She encouraged David that only the Lord has held him back from the bloodshed and from avenging with his own hand, because the Lord is going to give him a permanent dynasty and he is doing the battle of God. Evil should not find in him throw out his life. She also said his life shall be bound in the bundle of the living God. She wished the she wished the lives that was prophecy from Jeremiah. She wished the lives of his enemies shall sling out as from the pocket of a sling. That was a prophecy from Jeremiah 10:18. She said, according to the promise of God, when David is back to the throne, there will be no grief to him, nor an offense of his heart that he have shed blood without cause and have avenged himself. She agreed that Nabal deserved judgment, but not by David, but from God. What an awesome counsel. What a verse of wisdom. From her speech, she was glorifying God and wished God for David. What an awesome peacemaker was she. It reminds us from Proverbs chapter 11, 16 says, "A gracious woman retains honor." A gracious woman retains honor. Then Proverbs 15, 1 to 2, "A soft answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger." Again, Proverbs 15, 33, "The tongue of the wise uses knowledge rightly." Isn't that true with Abigail? Dear sisters, Abigail challenges and teaches us how to be a wiseful woman, how to deal wisely during the situation that come against us, and how the situation that we can save our family from distress, from destroying, how to use our tongue to turn away the wrath. If you study carefully Abigail and follow her principles in our family life, many problems can be solved, and even we can be able to eradicate a divorce from our families and society. May the Lord help us to be like Abigail, to save our family and to save the marriage life. Now let us go to the final stage of the drama. David's anger was cooled down by Abigail's word of wisdom and counsel. He blessed her. Verse 32 to 35. Blessed be the God of Israel who sent you this day to meet me and keep me from bloodshed and from avenging myself with my own hand. Blessed are you and your wise advice. For indeed, as the Lord God of Israel lives, who has kept me back from hurting you, unless you had hurried and come to meet me, surely by morning light, no males would have been left for Nabal. What a blessing and an honor that she received from David, who is the man of God's own heart. A great lesson and a wonderful legacy that we all can follow and be blessed. What was the outcome? God himself judged Nabal and he died of a terrible death. God honored and rewarded Abigail by exalting her to be the queen of David. The reward of humility, patience, generosity, intelligence, honesty, and faith made Abigail a famous and wonderful peacemaker. Let us follow her courage and act of wisdom during an adverse situation to turn the wrath to blessing and to turn the destruction to be a blessed and victorious end. Let us follow Abigail. Father, I thank you for teaching us a great lesson from the life of Abigail and Nabal. Help us to be humble, prudent, courageous, and noble in our family life. In our Savior's precious name, precious and matchless name, I pray. Amen.